it's Geoff Chalmers here from discoverdoublebass.com. I hope you're doing well. I've got a lesson for you here today where we are looking at a beginner's bass pattern that gets you used to playing in first position. It's a bit of a cheesy, kind of lazy bass melody. You'll hear it. We play it four times, and on the third time, there's a little bit of a variation. But the reason why I want you to learn this is to give you something to play whilst you're working on your hand shape, and then also playing in first position, and there's a little bit at the neck block for those more experienced bass players. So let me play this bass line for you and you can see if you want to learn this. Okay, remember it happens four times and there's a variation on the third one, so try and listen out for that. Okay. So it's a really cheesy kind of bluesy, I don't know, melody. It's just something fun to practice whilst you're working on this half position. So let's remind ourselves, first position. Let's remind ourselves how we get to first position. Well, we know half position is just by the nut there, and then we're just one note higher. And if we are on the G string, we've got G, and then we should have A and B. So A under the first finger, B under the little finger. So you can check this note A against the open A to see if you're in tune. And then in between, we have the note B flat. So it's open G, A, B flat, B. Now the pattern starts D, G. So it's D, G. And then we play the open D at the end. And I want you to play this open D against the B so you can hear if your tuning's correct. So. And then the same pattern repeats down a string. So that's A, D, E, F natural, F sharp. And again, we let the open A ring, and then same thing happens down one more string. And there you've got the C sharp under the little finger and the E natural ringing out underneath. And the last bit of, the last bar is, which is A, and then F sharp, F natural, E, down to the D. Then, yeah, so. And then it starts again. So the pattern on at the end is D, A, then D, and then back to the open G. So if I play the last bit again, this is the descending line. So this pattern here, D, A, D, and then G again, when you play the A string, you need to mute the D with your left hand, otherwise it'll sound like this. Really messy, so you need to. That is, you know, that's a lesson in itself. You could spend a lot of time just D, A, and as soon as I hit the A, my left hand is muting the D, D, and when you play the D, your first finger or your finger on your right hand will mute the next string, and then the G. So let's listen to that pattern all the way through, all four bars. Try and let those notes ring out so you can hear against the open string if it's in tune. Now we're going to have a fill at the end of this variation. This is the third one. Here it comes. Back into the fourth one. So Before we look at the fill, just be really careful that your fingers aren't scrunching up, because for most people, what will happen is, when they're new to the bass, they'll establish the hand shape, but quite quickly as they play, they kind of relax a little bit and the fingers come together and it becomes a little bit less in tune. So be really careful to kind of maintain that hand shape. Let your weight fall back into the bass. Try not to squeeze with your thumb, and let those notes ring out. Because if you're out of tune, you know, it'll sound really horrible. And then there's this fill. So this is, you go to the neck heel, and your first finger on the note, D. D, E with your little finger, D, B with your little finger, A with your first finger. So the rhythm is one, one, and then back into the. So if I play that from the third time through the pattern and with the fill, time. And that's it. So you want to get used to going into this, the neck heel position. You can call it, you know, it's labeled different things by different people. But if we just think about the first position of the neck heel, so your first finger on the note D, you may have a bass which has an E flat neck where your first finger will actually land on the note E flat, so you'll have to scoot back a little bit to get the D. But the point is, you get those four notes. And yeah, just try and put that together, maintaining the hand shape, looking out for the hands kind of naturally squeezing together, letting the notes ring so you've got that nice tuning anchor. And then, you know, working through your positions, maybe saying the notes out loud, really getting comfortable with A, B, C, C sharp, you know, whatever the notes are that you're playing. You want to find a way to really work a position of the double bass. And I think learning these simple melodies and scales, of course, will help you. You could practice your A major scale, shifting back into half position, shifting back into first position. You could practice, you know, whatever you like, but adding in little patterns and bass riffs like this can really help you. And I have a beginner's course over at Discover Double Bass where I have lots of these kind of shorter patterns, not all of them as quite as cheesy as this one, and you can kind of use them to help you on your journey. So we present a technique, we probably look at a scale and arpeggio, and then we play the bass line. And then off you go, do your work, move on to the next lesson. So something there for you to get stuck into. And yeah, best of luck with your practice. If you want to learn more about what we do, please go and visit discoverdoublebass.com. We have several courses for beginners that I know could help you on your journey. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.